Khaled Omar. It's a name you may not recognize, but the many people whose lives he helped save are unlikely to forget it. Because Khaled Omar was a volunteer rescuer in Syria. Now, there's word that he was killed in an airstrike in Aleppo. Omar was perhaps best known for the dramatic rescue of a small child. Bombs destroyed this Syrian apartment building, and he, along with other members of his volunteer rescue group, the White Helmets, dug for hours to pull the child free. The video of the rescue went viral and shone a light on groups like the White Helmets, volunteers who run towards the wreckage of war as others run away from it. There are about 2,600 members of the White Helmets. CNN's Sanjay Gupta met some of them last year.
There was no 911 system. There was no ambulance that would show up. There's no power in a lot of places. And so when violence would occur, when a bomb would get dropped, for example, there literally was no one to call. So these guys said, we want to take care of our own.
And it's a dangerous job. They often become targets.
Essentially, a barrel bomb would drop into an area, and these guys, again, would come in to help. And literally, the chopper, whatever, still flying overhead and drops another one after all the first rescuers show up. It's really, you know, that's sort of mind-numbing to think about the degree of evil involved in that.
The White Helmets are memorializing Omar on Twitter, showing glimpses into the heroic acts that defined him, calling him hero to the young and hero to the old.
These cities are oftentimes getting decimated. They get decimated by losing just basic services. And you have one of two choices at that point. Many people leave.
Khaled Omar chose to stay to help when there was no one else to call. He leaves behind a wife and a three-year-old daughter, and also a legacy that is a glimmer of light against the darkness of war. Hannah Vaughan-Jones, CNN, London.